Kalitzis, co-founder and co-owner of Valor Spirits. Spent about 8 years in the U.S. Army Reserve, spent some time serving in Iraq. Served in Iraq again in Afghanistan as a civilian intelligence officer for a while. I was a volunteer fireman here in my hometown of Amerenik, New York. I've been a member for almost 15 years. My brother-in-laws are both police officers in northern New Jersey. And got a commitment to serve in the community, and got together with my partner here.
Hi, I'm Alex Mackowitz. I'm a Connecticut native. I've done about 20 years now of events and event planning with product launches, from launching vehicles from the Bentley to different innovative products like the working with the TED Group, some of the smartest and innovative companies out there. I teamed up with this guy in Fairfield, Connecticut, is where it was born, about 2 years ago.
Just about.
And we knew we wanted to do something that we would give back, make a product that wouldn't be there kind of without us. And we just teamed up with the mission and wanted to make a solid product of good value, and that the consumer could see and appreciate the mission, and of course what other people, when they go above and beyond, we can feel it for both of us. And that was, yeah, a big part of what we felt was important. So it became a big part that was the backbone of building the product.
So we're two friends, two different backgrounds, mine more service oriented in terms of national security and fire service and the military. Al's in hospitality, food, beverage, and event management for big companies. And between the two of us, we said, okay, there's got to be a business model here. Like cops, like firemen, love veterans. We like vodka and whiskey. We're like, there's got to be a company here. So as Alex said, about 2 years ago, we set out to start a company. We decided the name on Valor Spirits. As any police officer, fireman, or service member who died in the line of duty would die committing an act of valor on behalf of our country. So figured, let's start a company. Let's figure out a way to take care of those who have taken care of us. So we set aside 10% of net profits from our company to take care of those who have made the ultimate sacrifice for us. So Alex and I have set up a charity board comprised of senior police, fire, and military officers. And their job is to verify that 10% of the funds are actually given. They have unfettered access to our books. And then they make the decision as to where the 10% contribution should go on an annual basis to make sure that they're taking care of their communities. And they're really best suited to do so. So it takes the politics out of it for us and gives us an opportunity to put a quality product on the shelf.
To respond to a potential disaster that, you know, a company might not need a new engine or hoses or something, but if there's a real tragedy for a family, this board member can say, you know, the wives who just lost their husbands might need that $1,000, or they might need that support. So he steps in and he's going to answer the tougher questions for us.
Yeah, and it's kind of, that's the nature of the job, whether it's the fire department, our police officers or the military, their job are to respond to crisis situations. So being married to a particular charity or a particular institution may not make sense, because in the event that you have a major, you know, natural disaster, like you were saying, or a terrorist attack or something, you want the ability to respond to the times of what's going on. So we want our charity board to be able to give funding where it's needed to take care of those who are taking care of us. So producing a quality classic American whiskey. It's 71% corn, 20% rye, 9% malted barley, aged in new American oak barrels for 6 months. So it's really a baby bourbon you get at a whiskey price.
And it is American whiskey. Everything about the product is from America, from the glass to the label, to the topper, to the cork, and all of the ingredients in the juice is all made in America.
Everything's here. And that's also the same with the vodka, which is not traditionally an American liquor. You think liquor in America, and you think, you know, Jack Daniels, you think, you know, middle America, you think way out there in the Midwest, and you think brown liquor. We make a classic, we're calling it a classic American vodka. It's a corn vodka distilled 6 times from corn that's grown in Kansas, non-GMO certified, gluten-free. It's got a little sweet taste to it, absolutely no bite on the back end. So, you know, we're proud of the juice that we're putting in the bottles. Yeah. We wanted to come up with some classic labeling issue that's handsome. You'd be happy to put it on your bar.
We went through several revisions to get to where it is now.
2 years and lots of late night tastings.
We just kept asking people what is wrong with it so we can improve it. Our egos were like, we'll take our egos right out of it. Tell us how to make it better. We want to do it.
Yeah. And that's how we started out, to produce, again, a quality product, great packaging that you'll be happy to put on your bar. And then coming in at prices that also took care of the retailer and took care of our distributor, with a give back mission that really take care of other people. So we were talking one day, like, there's these 80-year-old billionaires on TV that talk about giving out, you know, their life savings and work, you know, when they die. I'm 30. Al's
38,
32, but between the two of us, do I need to wait 50 years to give away money to take care of somebody else? If we can make that now and have an impact now, there's no need to wait a half a century. So that's who we are. That's Valor Spirits.